It goes without saying, it doesn't matter what you have. Nothing other than Jesus brings real joy and satisfaction. And so you could prophesy all week. You could get money all week. You're going to reach a place where you realize that you are still miserable. You're still wretched. You're still flustered. Because the truth of the matter is, it doesn't matter what you have. It doesn't bring true joy or happiness. I'm preaching already, y'all. Amen. Amen. And so, I was home and my spirit was just turning because I don't want to be men pleasers. I don't want to be the preacher who preaches just for hype and for persons to feel good. And after you felt good, you go right back in that situation and you are twice defeated. Anybody understand what I'm trying to say? Anybody understand? Wait, let me understand what I'm trying to say. So, for everybody that Jesus healed, if you notice, he did not just heal them and send them back in their situation. He healed them and sent them another way. Which means that as long as God has touched you, he touches you because he wants to change where you are and who you are. And so we don't want this fasting service to be predicated on just how good we can feel and boy, the preacher make me feel better about myself. Oh no. It is about self-assessment and you assessing your life after the preacher is finished and see as to whether or not this is something you want to have to do week after week or is it a case where you are moving gradually. You understand?
Yes.
Praise God. Because you know, it's so easy to get in the rut of just having church and coming to church and, you know, just look at church on Wednesday. All the persons who go to church on Sundays, whatever. Praise God. So we still have persons who come to fasting every week, but they don't go to church on Wednesday, on Sundays. What does that mean? That's very important and significant. Because anybody who knows anything about being saved, just Wednesday alone can't do it. Wednesdays are more deliverance based. Come on. Amen. Sundays, you know, I'm word-oriented and I'm in a different mode on Sundays. And so you need a balance between both. Let me just say this for the record. I know that there are many persons who are really trying to change their lives. I know that personally. I know that. That some people are really, really trying to change their lives gradually. But it is clear that there are some who come for every other reason than changing their lives. And if you're coming for any other reason than to change your life, to change how you live, to change the relationship that you have with the Lord, then more than likely your coming is in vain. Because that's the sole purpose of me being here. And this is not something I do because I have the time. I really don't have the time most of the time. I make time for this. There are times when I'm preaching all the way in the country. I've been doing a week of crusade in the country. And I make sure to tell them that on Wednesday, I cannot preach there. I have to be here. Why? Because I believe that people's lives are dependent on this fasting service. Now I want to ask a question. How many of you have been blessed since you've been coming to this fasting service? And like I said, this morning is a real, real serious morning. I believe God wants to talk to somebody. This morning is going to be a morning of healing, deliverance, and miracles. Amen. How many have been really blessed since you've been a part of this fasting service? Praise God, you can definitively live there and as a boy. You know, my life has been better. Praise God, since I've been coming here. Now, if you're coming for the first time, lift your hand. Today's your first time. Praise God. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. I notice y'all not going with the challenge anymore of the person who brings five, four people or more. Praise God. You get a nice gift.